Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy to see you again. And if you're new, hi, my name is Sandra and this is my channel. If you're not yet subscribed, please go ahead, click the subscribe button down there, and then you'll become a member of a lovely and cozy family here on my channel. So today's video is going to be my last Yessi and Nobi for 2017, and that is so weird. It's really, really weird. 2017 is almost over. We have about 2 or 3 days left. 2 days. One. Oh my god. I cannot believe 2017 is over, but it has been an incredible year. And the year I had my first year on YouTube, and I got a job or 2 jobs, and just everything was so good in 2017, and I really hope in 2018 is going to be the same way. But today's video is going to be my Yessi and Nobi before December. And first of all, I have to admit, I haven't worn that much makeup in December because I got a new job, and at that job we are working with food, so I don't wear much makeup on work because you cannot wear too much because the danger of the makeup to falling in the food and all that. But when I'm wearing makeup, I'm wearing full glam makeup like I'm doing today. And yeah, if you like to see my Yessi and Nobi for December, then keep on watching. So the first product I wanted to mention is a product I've been loving in December, and I did not expect that at all because I'm not a huge fan of some of the other products from this brand, but this product is amazing. This is the Max Factor Facefinity All Day Primer. This is amazing, you guys, really amazing. It does keep your makeup on for a long, long time, and I feel like it's blurring my pores a little bit and make my skin more even and smooth. I love this primer so much, and I have used this a lot this month in the days I've worn makeup. So I am really, really happy I found this primer, and it's a bit affordable primer too, so it's not too expensive. So I highly recommend this one if you can pick it up, or if you can find it anywhere, pick it up. It's really, really good. The next product is from a really affordable brand, and I love this brand so much. This is from Colourpop, and this is the Super Shock Shadow in the shade Sailor. This is incredible. Really incredible. This is so pretty. This is not a full-on pigmented eyeshadow, but it's just a flush of color, and this is so pretty. This is one of the most prettiest eyeshadow I have seen in a long, long time. This has some really pretty nude pinkish shade, and then got this shift of green. This is so gorgeous, and the eyelid is phenomenal. So if you can pick this up, please do it, because this is amazing. Next product is a product I found in Lille here in Denmark for about 6 months ago, I think. And that is this one. This is the Rouge Powder by Cien, and this is in the shade 02 Nectarine. This is such a stunning color for fall. I love this shade so much. I got it on my cheeks today. And this is such a stunning color. This is not a matte color, but it's not a shimmer. It's between a sheen, I think. A sheenish color. This is so stunning, and I have used this quite a lot, and yeah, you can barely see it, but it's not too powdery, it's just creamy, and it glides on really, really beautifully. I highly recommend this one if you can pick it up somewhere, because this is stunning. And last but not least is a old but a goodie. This is the Wet n Wild Comfort Zone palette, and I love this palette so much. But not the entire palette. I want to talk about one of the shades in this palette, and that is this one up here. I love this shade for highlighting. And I didn't know this shade was suitable for me because I'm so fair. This is the most stunning highlighter I have seen in a long, long time. And yeah, it's looking a little bit too yellow in the pan, but it's stunning on the skin. I'm wearing it today, and this is just giving me the beautiful glow from within. I love this shade so much for highlighting. So if you have this palette and you haven't tried it out as a highlighter, do it. This is phenomenal. So that was all my Yessi, and now we're moving on to my Nobi. And the first one being this one. This is the Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color, and this in the shade HD Glam, I think. I cannot see the color on this one. Why can't I see the color? But this is a metallic finish, and I'm not a huge fan of it because, first of all, this is not pigmented enough. This is really, really sheer on the lips and almost disappear. And I don't know why. It got this really jelly type of feeling, and I don't like that. And I don't feel like this applicator is picking up that much product. I don't know if you can see this at all. I'm just trying to wipe off this and then put it in here. Can you see that? It doesn't have any product on this one, and that is so weird because this color is stunning, and I'm mostly using this on top of my lipsticks just to make it more glossy or more plump, but that is about it. I don't like it, and that makes me so sad because when I purchased this in the US, I was like, yes, I finally found a metallic lipstick that is not too metallic, but just a little bit, but this is not a good thing. And the last product is a product I'm not a big fan of, and yeah, I don't like this. I don't like the scent of it, I don't like the feeling of it, I don't like to use it, it's too messy. This is the Raw Natural Beauty by Coffee and Scrub, and this is the Coffee and Coconut Body Scrub. This is so messy in the shower. I am taking a small amount of this just to work with some part of my body, and this is so messy. I don't know if you can see it. And the scent is so strong of coffee. No, I don't like coffee in general. I really like the scent of coffee when it's made, but I don't like this. This is so awful, and you cannot smell the coconut in this one at all. Really old. And it's so messy to use. I got this coffee scrub all over the shower after using it. And to wash it off, it was a nightmare. A really big nightmare, because it was sticking to my skin so hardly, and I had to constantly wash it off just to get it all off. And when I'm using my shower gel afterwards, I still have some dust of product all over my body. So I am not a big fan of this, and I'm going to throw this out because no thanks. So that was everything for my Yessi and Nobi for December 2017, and I cannot wait to start to do my Yessi and Nobi for 2018. So if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit subscribe down there, and then I will see you in my next video. Bye.